Hi, I'm Scodysk, and the latest with Stadia is, well, a lot. First of all, and most importantly, there's a release date, 9 AM Pacific time on November 19th. Next, there's a solution to Google's latency problem, and it's called negative latency. What does it mean? What can it do? I'm not sure, but I'm going to try to explain it out. And lastly, more info on how Stadia is already changing the gaming scene. But first, the release date. Yes, the release date is set a little over a month from now, which confirms that we will have a release in November as planned. This is an excellent time for Stadia to come out, right in time with the other big releases of the year, including Modern Warfare and Death Stranding, which, by the way, broke my heart by giving me the hope of seeing Death Stranding on Stadia at release. Damn you, Kojima! Anyways, if you pre-order the Founders Edition of Stadia, keep an eye on your inbox and double-check your address. Next is negative latency. When I first heard of this, I joked with my friend, "What, are they gonna predict our movements?" And he said, "Huh, yeah, the entire game is just gonna be a cutscene." And then we laughed and laughed, until we realized that, yeah, that's exactly what's happening. As much as I'm pulling for this to be a win in Google's book, I can't shake the feeling that this is Exhibit A of Google's unchecked hubris. I hope not, but negative latency, really? And finally, more impact of Stadia even before release. PlayStation has reduced the price of PS Now by 50%. Microsoft xCloud's hands-on preview has begun, and there's a new Nvidia Shield on the horizon. Nvidia hasn't announced anything specific yet, but this YouTuber bets his 26 subscribers that there will be more info on the rekindling of GeForce Now, especially hot on the tails of the GeForce Now app. And that's all I've got for now. Thanks for watching. This is Scodysk, signing off.